So this will be a video walkthrough of this marketplace plugin called Prefab Tools. There's other prefab plugins that are on the market, but this is the one I've used for the past few years. It's gone through a lot of feature updates and quality of life updates, and there's always room for improvements. But this is the one that'll kind of help show people the purpose, the intent, the complexity, but also the power of approaching development with prefabs. So this is a scene I've already set up with existing prefabs. They're in the content browser that you can't see because it's off screen. Over in the outliner, you'll see right off the bat, there's a column already devoted to prefabs. This color will change based upon whether or not this is a closed prefab, an open prefab, a prefab that's not connected to the source, meaning you can make as many changes as you want, save it in the level file, and it'll maintain those changes. Of course, this is all under the classic level structure, not the world partition structure, which is a completely separate ball of wax. Over on the right side is your details panel and a dedicated prefab panel as well. Once you select a prefab, there is a small section inside the details panel for the most common features, functions you would want to do. And then there's a much larger one, which does pretty much everything. So let's try to step through this. Oh, there's also a context menu as well, right here. So some of these are duplicated, like the eyeball, the lock, the connected is up here. It's also buried inside of here. So eyeball is for hiding and unhiding. It's a little bit different than the native hiding and unhiding. And if you actually want to edit that, you can't go in and edit until you unlock it. Once you unlock it, it expands on the outliner. You can see the colors change. It's also a nice light green box. Connected means that you can make changes and it won't save it, and it won't accept changes from the source. You can, of course, revert right off the bat. You can, of course, apply changes back up to the template and everything used within the world. Converting to normal will take the prefab itself and just turn it into a parent node with all the children attached to it if you just want to strip out the whole prefab architecture. You can also choose just to destroy and keep children, which means I don't need a parent object. I just need a bunch of loose objects in the world, which is great if you have a pre-made set of things that you want to use somewhere else in a completely different way. This is a great storage unit for developers. A really powerful thing that I've only seen on this plugin is the ability to generate a blueprint. In other words, you can do the native Epic prefab as a blueprint. So for people that don't have this plugin, you can still generate a blueprint and send it to some other project and it'll work just like a prefab. I'm actually using those already in Unreal 5. Let's step through this thing with some examples. So I will, and also the context menu expands a little bit. I use this shortcut a lot, which allows you to select the parent object again. And there's also shortcuts for all these things, but I don't have them memorized. So that's just a typical duplicate. Let's go and make some changes in here, something obnoxious. Now if I apply it, lock this guy up. I'm gonna do a that was the embedded duplicate no repeat, because if I choose to duplicate it with the native option, it reverts back to its original template. There's also a save icon here if you want to save those changes. I've already locked it up. This option here allows you to duplicate it, so you can save it as a completely new prefab with the changes you have. Quick apply and quick apply only selected. This is, let's see if I get this to work. This is a new feature I haven't quite used. So let's go into here. We'll unlock this one. We'll grab something else. No, not that. Unlock it. Now, if I do a quick apply, boom, It applied all the changes to this one. Now, since this is all still connected, they all accept the changes. Hey, there's also an undo, which is fantastic. If I disconnect this guy, let's see what happens now. Boom. So it's disconnected, but it accepted changes for things that haven't been changed in the unconnected one. Now, this is a fuzzy space that we can try to figure out and go deeper in, because there is some other logic inside of that to be able to control individual object changes, not the larger prefab itself. Mark target. If I mark target, it marks this one prefab. Any object I add from the content browser will automatically get added to this prefab. You don't have to go to the process of attaching and detaching, manually sliding them around in the world, in the layers, in the levels, in the outliner, none of that stuff. So that is fantastic. Variant. This is the feature that's new to me as well. And for this one, it's got the right idea, but I could be using it wrong. So the idea behind a variant is that if I go into here, let's grab this and I'll scale this up. So you should be able to tag this as a variant. And then within the prefab itself, it should show up as an array of property changes. This is not populating. I'm not sure why. I think that's just me using it wrong. But this is a way that you can say, I want everything else in the prefab to accept any updates that I do to the source, except for this one item. Now, this is different than choosing to not connect it. Not connect it means I don't want anything in the prefab to accept any changes. So between these two options, we can then control what is going to be individualized and still contained in the prefab versus what will accept any future changes anywhere across the whole game project. And you can see over here, there are color code changes, which is really great. Let's see. Pivot snap. Let me grab a different one over here. Now what I'm going to do in here is go into here, select some trees. I'm going to make a new prefab. You can do an empty one, but I'm going to go over to the browser over here. Let me actually go to my prefab folder. Then grab those trees again. New prefab. Boom. It automatically prefixes the file name with prefab. That's nice. So now I can have a child object inside of a prefab. So you can nest these things if you want to, which is also great. So just to kind of show this, let's raise this one up and go back to the parent and apply and lock it. And that means the tree should jump up over in this side. Boop, there they are. So you can have nested ones as well. So we'll go back to, we'll unlock this guy. So we're editing just the child object inside of an open prefab. When you create a prefab, it creates the pivot point based upon the last selected object. So let's be like, I selected a tree. I don't like that. So this plugin author also has a pivot plugin. He's included parts of it here. You can set the pivot if you want, which means, let's see, and I just duplicated. There is a way to move the pivot point within Unreal. I can't remember off the top of my head, but you can also use these quick options as well. So now I've just added a different pivot, and I'm going to apply it and lock it. So it goes back to where it is, and apply and lock this one as well. Boonk. So now that pivot's always in the middle, and there is an actual prefab object in the world. Let's open this. Let's take this, and let's see what this does. boom, snap the floor, it goes to the bounding box to the nearest object, or pivot to just the pivot's collision point. New prefab from selection, which is what I did over in the content browser. You can also isolate these guys, which is really nice. Hey, I'm only want to work on that. The visualizer is a way that you can, there's a bug with this right now. I don't know why it's refreshing like this, but you can see over here, it just turns everything into a big old block. So when you're looking across the level, you can tell exactly what a prefab is and is not. There are some other just handy dandy features. Like if I unlock a bunch of these guys and I'm like, I don't know which ones are there. I can select all unlocked. There you go. I can select all disconnected. There's a few in there, right? I can select same prefabs. Let's see what this does. Boom. I can also select all of them and do group changes as well. Let's reconnect them actually. There we go. There's also a layer feature, which is really nice. So if you've grabbed a bunch of objects and they are scattered across multiple layers, which I don't think anyone's using, but I do think we should use that, is that this is a quick way to organize it, saying everything within this prefab can go to its own layer that the parent prefab object is actually associated to. Okay, so the other thing is you can also go inside of the game editor settings, or you can just go right to here. He's got a nice shortcut to everything that it does. You can change all the colors that you want. You can change the materials. Just everything that you'd want to do related to this thing is buried here as well, which is really nice. This is a little bit out of date because I haven't updated it. But you can see down here, there's an example of all the different color types. You could easily see right off the bat in the Outlander to understand exactly what's going on in the state of prefabs. That's another thing of the visualization. You can go to this page to get to the author's page, where he has all the latest information about it. He also has some other plugins, which are nice. I said we're already using the pivot tool. The mesh tool I'm using, which is really great if you want to do shape building inside of the editor, I have not used the instance tool. So that's a real basic overview. The important thing I want to say is you can nest stuff, you can lock and unlock stuff, you can instance change stuff. I call them deltas. He calls them variants. There's also visual feedback as to what you're doing. You can't normally edit these things unless you are actually opening into that thing. You can share these things. You can convert them into blueprints. It's easy to revert these things, to apply these things, to select these things, to explode these things. So give that all a look.